Warning. Every installment of the massive JMO review will contain spoilers.
Hello, and welcome to part 3 of the massive JMO review. I am reviewing 100 Women, also known as Girl Fever, today. It was a 2002 comedy about an art student who is trying to make a depressed woman whom he has feelings for smile again. Another student, Jennifer's character, offers to help him in his quest to get the girl, but she ends up falling in love with him during the process. My overall rating for this film is a 2 out of 5. Honestly, the score is only that high because the audio was synced, the lighting was good, and the film editing was without glitches. The only part of this film that looks like any thought actually went into it was the scene in which Chad Donnell's character is drawing all over Jennifer Morrison's body with a Sharpie. It was a cute scene, however, I do wonder how long it took the makeup people to put that on her and take it off, because that was an excessive amount of Sharpie. It appears as though this film was written by a sexually frustrated teenager. The overall sexual tone in this film was bordering on misogynistic. In film school, they teach you that the goal is to make men want to see your film. The idea is that women will watch anything, whether it is a chick flick or an action film, whereas men are more picky as to what they spend their money on at the box office. I believe that this film was written with that in mind, because though it is classified as a romantic comedy, it is filled with man jokes and overly sexualized women characters. The jokes and physical humor weren't very funny, in my opinion, and besides the dialogue between the two main characters, the script was lacking substance. There was no explanation as to why the minor characters, such as Holden and Mr. Willens, behaved and reacted to situations in the odd ways that they did, which was unsettling. I like to know why a character is the way they are, and this film doesn't explain that. I will give this film one positive review point, though, which is that there was character growth for most of the characters between the beginning and the end of the film, which is always important. Audiences love to see a character change for the better over the course of the film, and this film shows that. As far as Jennifer is concerned, it was one of her earlier works, so she was not as experienced as she is now. There was a point where it appears that she broke character for about half a second during the Sharpie scene, when he was drawing the necklace. There are some parts where you could tell she was acting, or overacting in a sense, but again, I attribute this to the fact that it was the beginning of her career and she hadn't yet mastered her acting skill. I don't think I will watch this film again, but if you want to, it is on Amazon.
It's you, isn't it? Hey, what do you say I take you out for a cup of coffee?
No. I can't. My mascara's all smeared. Oh, and I smeared my eyebrow tint.
It's okay. It's okay. You can just wipe it off.
I can't. I just spilled the remover. I'm a freak.
Hey, come on, Annie. Let me take you out. See? We can be freaks together.
The next review will be for the film Alpha Alert, also known as Event 15, which is actually a good film, so stick in for this review. I liked this movie. We're getting to movies I like now. All right. See you then. Bye.
Don't touch me!
Too fucking crazy!
Don't fucking touch me!
Open up the hatch just to let the radiation in!
Get those back!
And the prize?
Come on.
Crazy Bill!
Give them back! Give them back!
You're gonna beg like you did in the video, huh?
Christ, what's fucking wrong with you?